text is Luke chapter 17, verses 11 through 19. On the way to Jerusalem, Jesus was going through the region between Samaria and Galilee. As he entered a village, 10 lepers approached him. Keeping their distance, they called out, saying, "Jesus, Master, have mercy on us." When he saw them, he said to them, "Go and show yourselves to the priest." And as they went, they were made clean. Then one of them, when he saw that he was healed, turned back, praising God with a loud voice. He prostrated himself at Jesus' feet, thanked him, and he was a Samaritan. Then Jesus asked, "Were not 10 made clean, but other 9, where are they? Was none of them found to return and give praise to God except this foreigner?" Then he said to him, "Get up and go on your way. Your faith has made you well." The word of God for the people of God.
There is no doubt about it. I love this passage of Scripture. It is one of my favorite passages of Scripture because it illustrates several things just point blank. And if you were at the early service, you heard me say this. The person who disobeys Jesus is the hero in the story. Think about that for just a second. 10 lepers were cured. 1 disobeyed Jesus and did not go to the priest. He came back and said, "Thank you." And he is the one that Jesus praises at the end of the story. And I've got to tell you, dear friends, sometimes we end up in that category more often than we end up in the other category. This passage of Scripture is set in an interesting place in an interesting time. Jesus is on his way to Jerusalem. Everything in his life is geared towards making it to Jerusalem. Everything about his role with the disciples is about representing God on his way to Jerusalem. He is on his way to Jerusalem, and he is in a border region. He is in a place where countries come together. And he is in a place that you would not really expect him to be if he was a holy man. Jesus has a habit of going in those places like Samaria. He has a bad habit of talking to people like Samaritans. He encounters people as they are and who they are, and he gives them the grace of God in their lives. In this particular case, we have 10 lepers, people who were afflicted with the disease of leprosy or some sort of skin disease that was visible, that made them outcast, that made them marked in the eyes of the world. There was nothing they could do to relieve themselves of this suffering. The Old Testament directs the people to put them out of the community, and they are to live out of the community by themselves. They are to warn others when they come into contact with them. They are to say, "Leper, unclean, stay away." Can you imagine a life like that? A life of isolation where your only friends are afflicted by the same disease that you're afflicted with. And when you encounter people who are not afflicted with that disease, you're required to identify yourself. Leprosy, stay away. My goodness. What would it be like if we treated people with diseases that way in our time? Cancer, stay away. Diabetes, stay away. But leprosy, you could see. Leprosy was a deformation of the skin, and people were afraid of it because they thought it could be transmitted by a touch or by germs that they didn't understand or know about, but by something that was going through the air. They thought that there was an uncleanness to the person, and they were afraid. And so they made rules about how those people who were afflicted by that disease had to behave. And they are doing exactly what they're supposed to do. They see Jesus and his group of disciples, and they say who they are. We are unclean. We are lepers. And then they say, have mercy on us. And what do you think they were asking for when they said, have mercy on us? You think they were asking to be cleaned and made whole and to rejoin society? Or do you think they were asking that they might get some fresh clothes or some food or some water? They would ask for mercy from anybody that passed their way. They lived on the outskirts of the inhabited towns and villages. They were on the edge, marginalized in every sense of the word. And they were dependent upon the mercy of other people who would leave for them maybe some cloth to use as clothing, maybe some old piece of clothing that they could not use themselves anymore. Maybe they would leave for them some food. Maybe they would leave for them some other useful items. But those were acts of mercy that people were commanded by the law to do, to take care of those who could not take care of themselves. And so as they encounter, this group of 10 lepers encounter Jesus and his disciples on the way to Jerusalem, there they call out for mercy. And Jesus does some really interesting things here. He doesn't really speak with them. He doesn't really teach them. He doesn't touch them. He doesn't examine them. He commands them. Go and show yourself to the priest. Now, if you look in Leviticus, you'll find, I believe in chapter 13, that there's a place where there's a ritual cleansing that takes place. A ritual that verifies that someone has been cleansed by God or by some other force, and their leprosy has departed from them. It requires that the priest examine them, and when they find no leprosy on them, then they send them into an isolation, a time of 40 days of cleansing, and then they examine them again to make sure that they were really cured, and then they allow them into the community. They restore them literally to life in the community, both the community of faith and the village or city or township that they lived in. They were able to resume life as everyone else had life. In Jesus commanding them to go and show themselves to the priest, there is an assumption that when they get to the priest, they will be worthy of examination, that they will have been healed. The very act of these 10 turning and heading towards the priest to do as Jesus commanded is an act of faith. An act of faith that they are indeed made whole. Even though they don't feel it yet and they can't see it yet, they know, they trust. An act of faith, trust Jesus' word to go and show themselves to the priest. Now, I've got to tell you that if you showed up to the priest and said, I'm cured of leprosy, and he says, take off your shirt, and you have leprosy, that's not a good conversation to have. In fact, it can end one of two ways. He can run you out of town, or he can stone you to death. Not a good conversation either way. And so, it's a real act of faith in the command and the word of Jesus to go with this on me and show myself to the priest. As they are moving in that direction, they realize what has happened to their bodies and they are made whole. And one of them, a foreigner, a Samaritan, returns to Jesus and celebrates by laying flat at his feet and giving thanks to God. Jesus says, where are the other nine? They're obeying what Jesus told them to do. That's where they are. Probably they were Jewish. When they showed up in front of the priest and said, I'm of the house of Israel and I've been cured of my leprosy, they receive the rites of purification. They're where they're supposed to be. They're on track to be back into the community. And yet this foreigner comes back to Jesus and gives thanks. Why? Again, Jews and Samaritans hold nothing in common. In fact, they are long and bitter enemies. They are rivals in every way, in every sense of the word. He had no business to go in front of a priest. But he went and he gave thanks to the source of his healing. He celebrated that gift of renewal. He had no claim to that gift of renewal, by the way. Jesus is the Messiah sent to the house of Israel, right? He is the Messiah of the Jews. And here he is doing that thing that he does so often that just irritates the Jews to no end. He is extending the grace of God beyond the community of faith, even to those beyond the border of Israel, even to those who are lepers. He is giving away the grace of God. Jesus does that. He does it with a Samaritan woman at the well. He does it with a slave of a centurion. He does it with whoever he meets who is in need. He doesn't really respect the confines and the limits that people put on the grace of God. And that is something worth celebrating. Because I don't know how to tell you this, but we're Gentiles. We are those people beyond the boundary. We are those people off limits. We are those people who don't belong. And Jesus has reached out to you and to me, and he has offered the grace of God to become a child of God and to be made whole. And to enter the kingdom. And that's worth celebrating. That's a gift that we have received that we take for granted. In fact, one of the commentaries says that Luke may have included this particular story in this particular way because the church in Luke's time had begun to think that maybe Jesus had come for them. And maybe Jesus had done all of this for them. And you know, some of our hymns and some of our singing and some of our poems tend to concentrate on how Jesus did everything for me. But Jesus didn't do everything for me. He did everything for us. He reached beyond what was supposed to be into the world, into people who had no claim on God. And he showed us that God has a claim on us and that God has a gift for us. And we celebrate that gift. It's a theme throughout the New Testament, by the way. If you look at the gospel stories, and Jesus tells these stories that don't make a lot of sense to us sometimes, called parables, and he says a woman lost some coins, and when she found the coins, she celebrated. And when somebody lost a sheep, and they found the sheep, they celebrated. And someone had a son who was absolutely out of his mind and went out and spent all the money. And when he came home, they celebrated. It's all about celebrating the gift of acknowledging that you're part of the kingdom of God. That's the role of the community of faith. That's the role of a disciple, is to celebrate the gift that God has given us, that has made us whole, that has made us redeemed, that has given us salvation. And it's not only our job to celebrate when God heals us, it's our role as a community of faith to celebrate when God heals someone else, when God reaches someone else, whether they're part of our group or whether they're just part of no group. Because God is reaching and giving grace to everyone who will accept it. This is a story about 10 lepers, and 9 of them went and did exactly what they were told to do, and one of them had nowhere to celebrate. He had no place standing in front of a priest because he was a Samaritan. And so he went back into the presence of Jesus, and he gave thanks to God in the presence of Jesus. And he was counted as faithful because he did that. May we live our faithfulness. May we be those kind of people who reach beyond the boundary. May we be those kind of people in that kind of church that celebrates the finding of the lost and the welcoming of those who are receiving the grace for the first time. May we remember what it was like the first time we realized that God's grace was for us and for our brothers and sisters. May we celebrate as if we had just received that gift, so that others can see us celebrate and dance and sing, and that they can be a part of the thanksgiving to God for the gift that is ours in Jesus Christ. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.